We get Matt Cardona taking on Nick Gage for the GCW World Title match. Tim, I've kind of ran through this card a lot, so let me take over.
Yeah. All right, so I'm watching this, and I have to go show my son. Again, 14, watches wrestling enough to, like, humor me when I'm like, dude, watch this, and know some things from, you know, from when he was younger. I was like, watch. I don't think he remembered Long Island IC, right? Like, he didn't remember Zack Ryder, but I was like, all right. So I tell him, I'm like, old WWE guy, watch this entrance. I was like, that's real security. Like, security's really got to get Matt Cardona to the ring because the crowd is in his shit, right? That's the first thing that jumps out at this. Security looked like they were almost about to get their ass kicked. Like, he needs 5-6 guys, was it? I mean, like, it was surrounding him, doing the whole pushing out of the way, but they're getting knocked over, and Matt Cardona's selling the whole thing. He's, fuck you, fuck this, get the fuck out of the way, fucking bitches. Like, I mean, he's the whole time doing the fucking head nod thing, loving it. And I was like, that was intense. And then I saw Nick Gage come to the ring, and it was worse. And he's the fucking crowd favorite. And I was like, Nick Gage is going to have to fight the fucking crowd to get to the ring. Like, it's so intense. And I mean, just the fucking tension in that place. And then to get into this match that is just, it's everything. It is the pizza cutters. It's the light tubes. It's the panes of glass. And Ryder tries to, whatever, Cardona tries to run. The crowd doesn't let him, right? Like, he then is just like, fuck, 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 the whole time, right? Everything that's happening to him, I love that, where he's just like, fuck, and just the whole time. And then, so it started to get weird. Okay, so they had the fake Jericho entrance, right? And it's a nobody, right? So the music hits, Gage gets distracted.
Some guy comes out.
And then this next crew comes out, which, not watching GCW for a long time, but they're telling the good, they're hitting the spot. Well, Kevin Gill's telling them enough backstory to know, like, this is longtime rivals, right? Like, or a longtime rival coming to his aid, right, against this team trying to get him. So I'm like, okay, but this is a lot of weird. At this point, I'm worried they're starting to lose me because I'm like, why all this extra interference? But then I get it. All right, it's his ex-nemesis helping him out. And then the swerve, he hits, gives him the Kansas City punt.
Yep.
Cardona gives him the thumbs up, gives him the fucking, the pinfall, and the crowd did something I haven't ever seen. I've seen them throwing stuff in the ring before, but not like this. Aside from maybe the chairs in ECW. This, but they asked for that. This was... fuck you, I'm going to kill you. And if there was 1,500 people in this arena, he got hit with 1,200 bottles. And this is to that casino that they do this place. This is why you're not supposed to sell bottles with the fucking lids on them. This is exactly why they don't do that in NFL stadiums. So when you throw it, it won't hit him like a projectile fucking missile. Matt Cardona had to hide himself and did his job. He did a great job of getting the spot, raising the title, flipping everybody off, getting everybody shit, but, like, he had to run for his life. This crowd was going to kill him. And you can see the picture behind us. His outfit was white. That thing is fucking real. Like, his outfit was pure white when he started this match. I can't tell you. I haven't seen anything like this ever, I think, that I can remember outside of maybe some early ECW stuff.
Yeah, this was fantastic. I liked all the storytelling. I agree with you, the 44 OH, I believe they're called. Justin will fact check us on that. But I like that. It went on just a touch too long, right? Because to your point, they're like, okay, what are we doing? Now it's Ricky Shane Page and Nick Gage joining forces. If you recall, I believe it was Nick Gage took the GCW World Championship from Ricky Shane Page. Ricky Shane Page, if you don't know who this is, RSP, he had a match on AEW Dark, by the way, which was cool. But he, as a heel, you want to hate a motherfucker, you can hate this guy. Oh, he has a face that you want to fucking drive your knuckle through his eye socket. He is a motherfucker. And so is his group, right? That Addison Cougar was in that group. And these motherfuckers, goddamn, I get angry just thinking about them. They're so fucking, they're great because I want to fucking hurt them. And to your point, Matt Cardona, the thing that I liked about the whole match is how he went from, hey, side headlock, hip toss, you know, 1-2, kick out, to then like, I'm going to throw my first light tube. And he doesn't throw it fucking well. He does the like half-ass, like, eh. And then everyone's
he
like,
did
the
WWE
like,
hitting somebody with it.
Yeah. Well, and then he kind of looks around. He's like, well, I've never done that. And then it gets a little bit more and a little bit more to the point where you described is he's like, I want out. And they're like, no,
yeah,
you're not getting
too bad.
Out of this.
Yeah.
And then he's like, well, fuck me. And gets in there. I love the spot with the action figures where he had an action figure set up, which why? It was just so fun. I believe there was even an action figure thrown at him when he won. Like someone picked up an action figure and threw at him.
They threw everything in this place.
It was, yeah.
He had to use the title to shield himself. It was insane.
I, it's so much fun because now we got some stories to tell. Because one, where does Nick Gage go? Does he go after Ricky Shane Page? Because that's the guy who fucked him out of this because he had the victory until then. Or does he say, fuck you, Nick Gage, or Matt Cardona. I want to get after you again. Or do they do a triple threat because
Cardona,
Ricky Shane Page?
Cardona's going to be around for a while. It seems he's selling this thing like, I'm going to be their champ. He went on Busted Open. He's like, no, I'm going to like help this company, you know what I mean, become better. Like, he's selling it like a heel, right? He's like, I'm going to become, you know what I mean, I'm going to still make this company better. Oh.
Yeah, let's talk about the post-match where he takes the fucking GCW championship to Disney World.
Yeah.
Are you fucking serious, man?
Yes.
Like, oh, it's so great. It was so great. God.
Yeah, he tweeted, he's like, I'm staying in a very expensive hotel with a very expensive fucking
And he had to give the title a deep wash because he doesn't know where it's been. And he's holding it up like next to Mickey Mouse and shit. It was just, he's the perfect champion for that fucking promotion right now.
Oh, God.
Oh God!
GCW is taking the wrestling world by storm, and it's just off the backs of this. It is an honest fervor. They've done some amazing storytelling to get this crowd so hype that they literally might have killed Matt Cardona if given the option.
Yeah, I'm already fantasy booking in my head matchups that I want to see. Right, so what I want to see, because I've seen two victories at their last two pay-per-views from, again, what I viewed, is I want to see Nick Gage go up against Ricky Shane Page again, and I want Matt Cardona in his first title defense to go up against AJ Gray.
Yeah.
Like, that's the fucking match.
And you can catch all this on Fight TV. It's, what, $5 a month? Something like that, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Well, the pay-per-views, I think, are like $12 to $15, which, I mean, I'm not trying to downplay, like, oh, that's
still
not
cheap.
Expensive.
Right.
Well, but it's cheap in comparison to an AEW pay-per-view, which is like $50. But if you don't have the money, then, you know, talk to Tim. He'll figure out how you can see it.
You can always watch pro wrestling somewhere, right?
Yeah.
.com, dot something, you know, watch pro wrestling.
Yeah.
If you want
to. There it is. So I'm just excited to see what the next step is with this promotion. I'm hooked in. Like I said, I got the MDK shirt because I was hooked with the GCW. And then when he does the promo on Dynamite before the match, I was like, I fucking love this guy. And just when he walked out, I'm like, got to get a shirt. I got to rep this guy. He's my favorite right now.
That crowd.
MDK all fucking day.
That's the weirdest thing is that he had to fight the crowd to get through, but it was because they wanted to love this guy so much.
Yeah.
And it was an aggressive love. It was like a, you motherfucker, let me hug you, you son of a bitch. It was the weirdest thing I'd ever seen. They were mauling him to just touch him. It was so crazy. I thought grown men were trying to kiss him on the lips. Like, it was insane.
Maybe they were.
And they were. Yeah, I think they were. Yeah. And not it. Like, I think they were just like, come here. Like, you're my fucking hero. It's insane.
Yeah.
It's insane. Just the entrances alone. That's all I showed my son was the dichotomy of the entrances. And then I was like, okay, watch when he wins this match. And it's like, first of all, remember the entrance I showed you? See his outfit? All right, here's how he went in the match. He goes, Jesus Christ, he doesn't even look like he has a shirt on. I was like, yeah. And then the heat from that crowd. I was just like, that crowd is like nothing I've ever seen.
Yeah, and if you want a really cool video to watch, go to Effie's Twitter account, and he shows the backstage run-up that Nick Gage takes to get into the crowd. He takes like a 15-yard sprint to then get into the fucking mob of people.
He's got
to
get a fucking force head start. They literally were shoving him back. Like, no, you're staying with us. You're staying in the crowd with us.
And another great little note that I loved about this match is how the ring announcer, who I don't know who that is, because the last time I saw it was Kevin Gill.
Yeah.
But how Matt Cardona was like, "You fucking Mark," because then he puts on the ski mask and he's like, "Represent,"
yeah,
you know, East Block. Well,
because I love, at first he's like, "It's Matt Cardona." Like, he's just like, "Fuck this guy."
Like, everyone hated that guy. And that
there was a fucking
great,
like, 6-year-old in the crowd with a ski mask on. Yeah. There for Nick Gage. I was like, why is this kid in the ski mask? They had a foam pizza cutter? Like, God damn it. Fuck. You would never, you could never, without pro wrestling, show somebody a picture of Nick Gage, full smiling, and be like, this is the guy that, like, 2,000 people in a casino hall were ready to die for. We're ready to fucking kill another human being for.
Yeah. I mean, what month are we in? We're in July going into August. I got to say, the spectacle of the year so far is Nick Gage versus Matt Cardona.
Insane. And it was, again, the 1,500 people in a casino fucking, like, conference room.
Yeah.
Insane. And it was the pro wrestling event of the year. Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely love it. Now,